the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Torah, I said to you,
I don't believe it. I don't believe it.
I said to you, I answered you. Now, answer, what is all this money scripture for the Old Testament?
I will answer that if you show me Muhammad in the Torah.
I answer you already my question.
Genesis?
Then, I'm telling you, that is not Torah. That is not Torah.
What is Torah?
That is not Torah.
You tell me what is Torah.
Torah is a book who revealed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Christian, to the Jew. Okay? Where is this Torah? I don't know.
No, okay. If that is the case, then the Quran says the Torah and the Injil is revealed by God, by Allah, in Surah 3, Ayah 3.
Yeah.
Surah 3, Ayah 3 says...
Revealed to Moses, yeah?
Yeah, he has revealed it
to Moses.
No, it doesn't say... Surah 3, verse 3 doesn't say to Moses.
Well, now it's for Moses.
Surah 3, verse 3 says the Torah and the Injil are revealed by Allah. So what you're telling me is a book that's revealed by Allah has been lost. So Allah could not preserve it? Is that what you're saying?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he didn't mention any preservation of the Torah and the Injil.
Okay, in Surah 3.
He said about the Quran, he will preserve it. He didn't say that.
No, he said about the Torah too.
Where is it? Show me. Show me where it is.
I'll give you a progression.
Yeah.
Can you open Surah 3 verses 3? Open Surah 3 verses 3. I'll give you the progression. Let's read Surah 3 verses 3.
Surah 3 verse 3.
What does it say?
Okay.
Read in English. Read in English. What does it say?
Yeah, just wait. Be patient.
Okay, so
he has sent down upon you the book in truth, confirming what was before it, and he revealed the Torah and the Gospel. Where is prison?
Calm down. Yeah. And then we go Surah 18, verse 17, 27.
Yeah.
Recite what has...
No, let me read it in Arabic. Just...
But I'm gonna read it.
Which one? No,
Surah 18, 27.
18. 18.
27. So we have established...
18.
We have established that the Torah and the Injil are revealed by Allah, which is His word. So 18 verses 27 says, recite what has been revealed to you from your Lord's book. Nothing can change His words, and you will never find any refuge besides Him.
He's not talking about the Bible.
He's talking about the Torah.
Where is the Bible?
He's talking about the Injil.
Is the Bible?
He's talking about the Quran.
No. No, he's talking about the Quran. Quran. Non-Bible, non-Injil.
Okay.
What Luma Uhiya Ilaika? He's talking about him. He's not talking about in the past.
No, his
he
words.
He's talking about now. He said, look, he not have in his hand the Torah and the Injil.
Sir,
he have in his hand.
We
only,
have established
no,
in Surah 3 verses 3.
No, no,
Torah and Injil.
Not lie about the Quran. Not
the
lie about the Quran. He said, what Luma Uhiya Ilaika? What is in your hand? He's not talking about the past.
Exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
Then he's talking
and
about...
And that's Allah's word.
He's talking about what he's in
that's
his
Allah's
hand.
Word.
He's talking
yeah.
about
that's the, Allah's word.
He's talking about the Quran. He's talking about the Quran.
It doesn't say Quran, brother. For your information, it doesn't say Quran.
Look.
It says Allah's
if
word.
If I give you a letter, okay, and I say to you, read what is in the letter. I'm talking to you about the letter of what I give to George Bush in 2003.
Okay, the letter includes the Torah and the Injil, because that's Allah's
no,
word.
No. He's not talking
that's
about
Allah's
that.
Word.
No, he's not talking about that. He's talking about the
You're
Quran.
Very...
He's talking about the Quran.
No.
He's not talking. No, he's talking about the Quran.
Say the Quran.
You can't lie. You can't lie. He has well, he didn't say the Bible, but he's talking now. About now, he didn't talking about the past.
Okay, let's see if you're consistent, sir. Let's see if you're consistent. I'm going to quote another Quran for you. Go to Surah 568. Surah 568 says, say, O people of the book, you do not
Surah
stand... 68. You do not stand on anything until you observe the Torah and the Injil and what has been sent down to you from your Lord. So if you're saying that the Torah and the Injil is lost, your God is saying you don't have anything to stand on until you stand on the Torah and the Injil. So how can your God say you have to stand on something that's lost?
Yeah. because
you're making it up.
Yeah, because they don't have the original one.
According to who?
Yeah,
according
they don't have the original one.
Okay, that's fine. You're making that claim.
Yeah.
But according to who?
Because they have posted.
According to who? According to Allah? Allah doesn't say they've lost it. Allah doesn't say that. Allah does not say that we've lost the Torah in Egypt. You are saying it.
Just answer my question. Let me answer the question,
no,
please.
No, Allah doesn't say it. You're making things.
Did I answer a lot of his question? Okay, answer one question I told you. Told me the oldest manuscript of the Old Testament.
Okay, that's fine. No problem. I can answer that. Yeah?
You see, he's still playing.
Sir, I can answer that. We've established, that you cannot answer the question on the Torah being lost. Allah doesn't say the Torah is lost. Allah doesn't say the angel is lost. He doesn't say that. You're making things up here. And you're asking me what is the oldest? We have the Qumran manuscript.
I'm showing you, your Bible. Look, I can show you from your book, your Torah, you lost it. Can I show you something?
We have the Dead Sea Scrolls. We have the Qumran manuscripts to prove that
Qumran.
Those, you don't know what they are?
I know Qumran. How I know? I didn't know.
I didn't say Quran.
Qumran.
And we have the Dead Sea Scrolls.
And
they're all there to confirm that we have the original manuscript. That's the answer.
Tell me dating.
I don't remember the date. This is your problem. Sir, doesn't matter.
It's proving from scholarship.
That's about the
ancient manuscript.
Sir, what matters
from a scholarly level, that is a validated original scripture. Regardless of that,
I'm asking, are you Christian? Are you atheist? I'm a Muslim.
Yeah. I'm a Christian.
Yeah.
I believe in Jesus.
Tell me the point here is, he's saying the Torah and the Angel is lost. He does not have a proof that his God said, my Torah and the Angel is lost. The only way he can refute that is saying, what is the oldest manuscript that you have? That does not refute my question to him.
I'm saying to you,
where is the Torah and
the Angel? He will show you the oldest manuscript you have. Okay, let's show you your book is lost.
According to who? He's not following scholars. Allah. He's following his own mind. He's following Zakir Naik and Ahmadinejad and whatever his imam says. The Quran does not say the Torah is lost.
Yeah.
The Quran doesn't say the Injil is lost. Yeah, it actually says it is preserved. Read Surah 568. Read Surah 543.
No, it didn't say. It didn't say it. What lie about it? Sir, show me. Show me where it said it's preserved. Show me where the word, the Bible, and the Injil was preserved. Remember?
I'll show you, and then what you're going to say is, what is the oldest manuscript?
Remember?
No, just
show me. If the Quran said it's preserved, that means it's preserved. If he said no,
Are you being objective, or are you coming from a biased mindset? Depends on your mindset. Are you going from a biased mindset, or are you being objective to which you Let's
read Surah 5.
Biased out.
Are you ready? Yeah? Are you ready?
Give me
your
proof.
I'm going to read your Quran. Have respect for your Quran. Surah 543. I'm going to read to 48.
Respect your Quran, this thing.
Respect your Quran. Surah 543, up to 48. I'm going to give you 5 verses. And then we're going to wrap up. It's kind of cold. My hands are freezing.
Surah 5, number?
43, 44, up to 48. I'm going to read it. Here.
43.
And how should they make you a judge while with them is the Torah, in which is Allah's judgment? Yet in spite of that, they turn their backs and they're not believers.
Whoa. Started with a bombshell for you.
We send down the Torah containing guidance and light. The prophets who submitted judged by it for the Jews, and so did their rabbis and the scribes, as they were charged to preserve the book of Allah and were witnesses to it. So do not fear the people, but fear me, and do not sell my signs for paltry gain. Verse 45. And we prescribe for them a life for life. This is in the Torah. An eye for an eye, a nose for a nose, an ear for an ear, a tooth for a tooth, and retaliation for wounds. And whoever remits it out of charity, that should be at the top. I just read in verse 45.
I just read in verse 45. Tell me where is preserved.
But who told you Bible is Torah?
Listen.
Yeah. I told them that.
Listen. And so did Bible. The rabbis and the scribes, as they were charged to preserve
the book of Allah.
Oh, and were witnesses to
Allah,
it.
Non Allah charged to preserve the book.
My brother.
The Jew, they preserve.
He's saying the Torah is lost. Can you show me where in the Quran the Torah is lost? Because I'm actually reading your Quran.
That's what I'm telling you.
You don't have respect for your Quran.
No. I'm telling you.
Show me the Quran where my Bible is lost.
Which the old, tell me the date of the old manuscript of the Old Testament.
Is this your answer? Is this your answer for saying, where did Allah say my Torah and the Injil is lost?
Just tell me the date.
I don't need to tell you the dates. I don't.
Yeah, that
it doesn't make sense what you're saying.
I don't. Me too, I don't. I don't have to tell you that.
And we followed them with Jesus, son of Mary, this is verse 46, to confirm which was before him the Torah,
God.
And we gave him the Injil containing guidance and light.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he charged the Jew to preserve the book, and they didn't. They lost it.
It doesn't say that.
But the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, "Inna anzalna dhikra wa inna lahu hafidun."
Are you creating your Quran?
You're going against history.
I think he's creating his own Quran. He wants to write his own Quran because they're embarrassed about the truth in their Quran.
I'm embarrassed.
You're creating your Quran.
You show me this. You
what you're saying.
You show me, echo. You see, bimastuhfidu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he charged the Jew to preserve the book. Thank you for this verse.
Okay. So it was preserved?
No.
They didn't. My brother, are you listening to yourself? You're not listening to yourself.
You listen to yourself.
Did it say they didn't? Does it say they didn't?
He said they charged them.
Okay, does it say they didn't preserve it?
Then tell me the old manuscript of the Old Testament.
Sir,
tell me.
Sir, in all fairness,
it's only 400 years before Jesus.
In all fairness,
1,000, more than 1,000 years gap. More than 1,000 years gap between Moses.
The book with truth confirming what was before it of the book as a guardian over it. So it's very clear.
It's not, he didn't say preserve it.
All right. Torah, Injil is guidance. Quran is darkness. Leave Islam, come to Jesus. God bless you.
Torah, darkness, Injil, darkness, and Islam is the truth.
It doesn't say that though. It doesn't say that.
Yeah.